They say every cloud has a silver lining. Let's go to CodeTalk. Hi, I'm Ian Thain. Welcome to SAP CodeTalk. And as I said, every cloud has a silver lining. Very contrived opening statement, I know. What we are talking about today, or should I say who we have got today, is Kevin Muessig. Hi, Kevin, thanks for joining us.
Hey, Ian, how are you doing?
And I won't make you do an intro because the CodeTalk veterans will know that you've been on CodeTalk before a while ago, and we're doing something new subject, cloud native, and something new for you.
Fairly new. I mean, as you know, I've done iOS mainly over the last couple of years, and then a little bit over a year ago, 1.5 years ago, I transitioned into the world of cloud native, and since then, I'm mainly working with Kubernetes and the SAP BTP Kima runtime, and creating content around that topic.
Cool. Well, that's where we're going to hit the ground running today with that. New time flies by so quickly these days. So excuse me for understating how long you've been doing this. But one of the things I have been noticing recently is that the advocates and you as part of the advocate team is putting together something called 2 Minutes Off. And you, because I recognize your voice, you are the guy behind the series 2 Minutes Off Cloud Native. Can you explain the series and what you cover?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so as many of you know, we have the SAP Developers YouTube channel, and on there we create educational content around SAP technologies. And at some point we decided we need something short and quick people can consume on an everyday basis. We wanted to do more fundamentals, right? Because a lot of the Tech Bytes videos and other videos on there, even the hands-on SAP devs things, are more concrete and detailed about the topics, and they go into like certain problems, and they're like, let's say 20 to 45 minutes long. And the 2 minutes are really about like fundamental understanding the basics of certain technology. And we've started covering like the biggest topics like SAP UI5 and ABAP, API basics by DJ Adams. And I'm doing the cloud native one where I talk about the fundamentals of cloud native technologies, mainly about Kubernetes and containerization, and really, really going in there and kind of just explaining the basics of it. Like, what is it? How does it work? What is the architecture behind it? Why is it important? Those kind of things.
It's great because I think, you know, having something that's that bite size where you can dip in and out, and also the fact that you're asking sort of, and I don't mean this in a derogatory way, you're asking really simple questions, you know, the building blocks, why this, why that, what about this, what about that? And then, you know, the sort of question sometimes if you're in like a room with some of the other folks in your team, you know, you may not want to ask because it's like, you know, maybe they're assuming that you know these things. But anyway, it's great. The fact it's, as you say, fundamentals, containerization, Kubernetes, running services on Kubernetes as well. So what are you sort of building towards any bridges of the BTP Kima runtime as well?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Of course, we have to start somewhere, right? So we're talking about Kubernetes. What is Kubernetes? What is containerization? Why do we need containerization? What is the benefit of it? What is Docker, for example? But we're building up towards actually having a service and wanting it to deploy it. And I use our amazing Kima runtime for that, right? Showing that, or actually planning to do that, because we're not there yet in the series. Mm-hmm. But I'm planning on using the SAP BTP Kima runtime as our fully managed Kubernetes runtime available on BTP, and taking all the knowledge we've built up over the time, putting together a service, containerizing it, and then pushing it into Kima, and then of course looking into the different aspects of Kima and why Kima is different than other Kubernetes runtimes out there and what the benefits are for our SAP customers and partners out there.
So still sticking to the 2 minutes, so future 2 minutes will do this. They'll do like, you know, the, you know, we are going to do build this, now we're going to push that out. So again, what you're sort of referencing maybe GitHub as well to just put some stuff up there?
I mean, at some point we have code samples and sample projects. Right now, as you know, we have the SAP B2P Kima runtime community spotlight month. So I've created that code challenge for that. And we have a GitHub repository with like a basic setup in there, and people can try out how to deploy a service to the Kima runtime, how to build their own service, those kind of things. And then I will utilize the SAP samples repository, of course, to put out more samples out there. But the Kima team itself, they're doing an amazing job creating samples on their own and putting that out there as well. Their samples are more towards specific problems you might have, like deploying the app router to Kima or deploying a CAP application to Kima, those kind of things. And in the 2 minute series, we're not going to into detail of those concrete problems, but more on how do I write a deployment YAML file for a Node.js application, and how do I push that into the Kima runtime? How do I set up my local development environment to be able to connect to the Kima runtime? Like those fundamental issues we're going to cover in a 2 minute series.
Okay. Well, we'll make sure that we're, you know, in the comments below that we'll put something with regard to, you know, your blog, your code challenge as well. But to get back to the subject, why do you think the topic of Kubernetes cloud native is really interesting to our developer community at the moment?
I mean, to answer the question, we kind of have to understand where Kubernetes is coming from. And as you might know, Google invented Kubernetes back then in 2014. It's based on the Google Borg system. So they had that issue where they had billions of users out there using their Google Mail, Google Calendar, like their software. And they had to build a platform which manages their applications and services in a highly scalable and resilient way. And that's where Kubernetes is coming from. And over the years, they open sourced Kubernetes because they said it's important that every cloud vendor out there, every person who wants to build something in the cloud should have access to that technology. So the Cloud Native Computing Foundation took over Kubernetes as an open source project, and everyone can contribute to it. And Kubernetes basically became, in my opinion, the industry standard for building cloud native applications and services. And of course, over time, different cloud vendors adapted that technology, and SAP did that as well. So if you're an SAP customer partner, SAP developer, and you want to build applications and services on the basis of Kubernetes, and you need a fully managed runtime, and you want to extend SAP solutions in a really, really easy manner, then the SAP BTP Kima runtime is the product you need.
Perfect, perfect. That's put me in my place. Actually, yes, you're the third evangelist in the last few code talks I've spoken to. And I just wonder whether, you know, actually I spoke to Nico first. Nico did a UI5 code jam. Michelle, mm-hmm. actually working on a SAP UI5 web components code jam in the future. What about a cloud native code jam with Kevin?
There's going to be a code jam about cloud native, definitely. There are different questions which are still open about how a code jam for cloud native could look like. Because if we look at cloud native, it's not a single technology you start taking in your hand and you start fiddling around with. There's a lot to it. So we really have to think about how we structure and build up a cloud native code jam. And we cannot just let people, like we cannot just throw people on the Kima runtime and say, just let's do it. We got to build up those fundamentals. We've got to build up the understanding of it and go towards a direction where people are actually in a spot of using the Kima runtime in the way it was designed for, and that is a fully managed Kubernetes runtime. And I'm not saying it's complicated. I'm not saying it's impossible for anyone to pick up. It's fairly easy. The Kima runtime makes it really, really easy to get onto the Kubernetes train. And actually, I like to say sailboat, not the train, because, you know, it's like all those nautical terms like Kima and Kubernetes. And so I like to use the term sailboat. But as soon as we or I put together, and I have helped there put together CodeJam, there will be a CodeJam. I cannot promise it's going to be this year. Could be. I'm not sure yet. But there will definitely be a CodeJam available for Kima and Cloud Native.
Excellent. Well, you know, one thing we can't talk about on CodeTalk are futures, but you know, you've given us a bit of a taste there, Kevin. Thank you so much. As I said during this CodeTalk, that we will put some comments down below with regard to, you know, your blog, and also the, if anybody hasn't seen the 2 minutes of series, we'll link it up there. But Kevin, as always, thank you so much for joining me on CodeTalk.
Always.